an almost identical injury has just about taken consecutive Six Nations opportunities away from Nathan Nicholls. But it was a blessing in disguise, and the timing was impeccable for the young English fullback, as all he really had to do was rest out for the week's break in the Six Nations competition. He's back for the next English match, which is against Ireland, and as the team is travelling so very well so far, he'll be making sure he can continue the trend of his side and take them all the way to his first ever Six Nations glory. Hello everyone, and welcome back once again to Cornflakes Crib and the Nathan Nicholls Be A Pro series, where we are back in the white jersey. If you tuned in to the last episode, you would have seen that the injury scare for Nicholls only lasted a week, and thankfully we are straight back into the team. We're up against Ireland, and Ireland have the first time we've actually played against Ireland. We didn't match up with them last year because we were obviously injured, so we missed out that whole episode with Ireland. But the Irish side still got a few names that many people will remember, the likes of Court Henderson in the second row, a whole new back row, Van der Vestes and Brown and Davies. In the back line, Marmion will be alongside Sexton. There's an O'Driscoll at 13, ominous signs there. And apart from that, it's new names on the wings, Butler, Barnes and Fogarty in fullback for the Irish. For England, nothing has changed here for the side, with the players who have proven to be very, very good for the English staying true in their positions. Why change it if it's just not broken? We were impressed recently with the likes of Jones, Stanley, Banahan played very well, as did Guy Armitage in the middle of the field. All in all, England's going very well. Big wins, big performances, and a good look towards the rest of the season. Kicking off though, it is our good old Mr. Buddy Playmaker, play kicker and playmaker for that matter, Nathan Nicholls, with ball in hand. He's going to kick off this match of the Six Nations. England looking to reclaim their place at the top of European rugby. Already facing the worst sides in the competition. And they've got to play now Ireland and the other sides from the top of the table, the likes of France is up there as well. They've been Wales and Italy. So here's the first break from Ireland, and busting away looks like Henderson. Offload looks forward, but they still carry on to Ireland. Numbers for the breakdown there for England, but it's still Ireland on the attack. Big tackle. England looking to force them into mistakes. Oh, they've turned it over. Now's the chance back. England going to the left, and a break turns around the corner, goes to the right, but Nicholls completely isolated. No one wanting to help him out. One phase, England lose the ball. Nicholls at the bottom of a ruck. Ireland switching way to the left, to right, to up and down, and the dummy, and all the way for the try. What a start from Ireland. Well, we've talked about it time and time again. You take Nicholls out of the defensive line and look what happens. The breakaway, look at this, switching left and right to left to right. And in the end, the gap opened up and Ireland goes straight through it. Well, how do you defend this? Look at all the players still huddling around the first breakdown there. The dummy around the outside of the English back rower. And he is in for a try. Ireland take the lead, and like we spoke about just before, already facing the worst sides of the competition. Now it is up to England to do it against the best if they want to take this title. Here's Sexton trying to curl it around, but it doesn't come his way. 5-0 though, Ireland will take that every day of the week. So Nicholls wouldn't be wanting this at all. Back to halfway he comes. He's kicking off again for the second time in the match. Already just 7 minutes gone on the game clock. And Ireland again pull it in, and they try to break away. That is a turnover though. Looks like Guy Armitage is the one with ball in hand.
Police.
England throw numbers into the breakdown. It's there for Jones, changes his mind, slips it around the corner. All sorts of trouble. Not really having an idea of where they want to go here, England. Big ball wide. Now it's the opportunity. Nicholls got it before he really wanted it. Oh, desperate pass. And he's given it away. That's a real shame. England had a massive chance to put some points on the board. It's wide. Nicholls commits early. Good tackle. Had to make it as well. He's thrown it over to Boot. That's a door. I was going to say, that is a game-breaking moment. But he's being hammered straight to touch as soon as he picked it up. Well, this is the time I always remember to do this, but it's almost too late because we've missed our time with high ruck commitment, which is always a shame. Here come Ireland, though. Numbers, width on the ball is great for the Irish, but that's good. Great defence there. Still there, though. Stanley put the tackle in. He did well. He's been a revelation on the left side. Where do England find possession? Not there as well. Oh, that's a great fan. The offload, exceptional as well. Ireland could go all the way. They will go all the way. Wow, that is unbelievable. Ireland have scored two tries. That one should never have been scored. Alessandro Brown. It was this fend here on Stanley. That's what did it. And the speed on the open side flanker. Too much for Stanley the winger. Which is almost embarrassing for the number 11. Look at that. Could not catch it up. He smoked him for a start. But could not pull him in. Ireland up 10-0. Can you believe it? So a big chance here for some vital points. Sexton. Same position as the last one. This time he cranks himself. And he adds the extra two. It's 12-0 Ireland over England. This is not the start that England would have liked at all. They're down by two tries. 15 minutes only on the score on the timesheet, though. That is not going to go 10 minutes as well. Big mistake from Nicholls. Ooh. Well, what's the call here? The ball went into touch off Ireland. And it's an Ireland throw. Wow, that's a very difficult one to pick. To the front they go, and Ireland pull it down easily. They look for width again. It's been their go-to play, but they opt to kick for a change. Into the end goal of England. It's pulled in. Whoa. Thought they might let that go dead. But you've got to look at what was chasing up. There was a lot of Irishmen. Kick down from Nicholls. 22 drop out it is. Ireland! Oh, carving! They're a real trouble, England! That is super defense, though. They could even look to turn this over. Do they? They do! They do turn it over! Now they need to support the play. They need to score next.
Advantage.
It's advantage, Ireland. Want to know what for as Nicholls went for a bit of a scamper. Forward pass! Where on earth was their forward pass? Oh, that is as backwards as anyone could see.
Bind.
Well, this referee is about the most backwards thing about this game at the moment. England get a rare chance to put something together, and they are robbed by the referee. Now it's back to defence for England. Ireland, what are they? They've been gifted every opportunity here at the moment, are the Irish? Still, they set it up. Dumbing open. Oh, that's another great break. Nicholls bulldozed! But he makes the tackle count. Turned over and hit upfield. Not a bad effort either. Ireland will get it now. They're just 60 metres out. Got to keep this pressure on here, England. Need another turnover. Oh, there's room out here for absolute miles. Oh, big tackle, though. England pile on the numbers, but they still don't get the reward. Nicholls, wow, we're in major trouble here. Ireland are carving us to ribbons. Nicholls puts in a very good hit, though. Oh, and his friends help him out for once. Turnover ball. Get up, Nathan. Nathan. Away we go, though. Now we're up and running. England away out. Oh, we've lost it already. Wow. I spend our whole possession on the ground. Good work. Turnover. Back to England it goes. Gets in there. Oh, wow. Holy hell, we are getting absolutely destroyed here at the moment. Nicholls puts a big one in. 32 minutes gone and we've had nothing go our way. And we're about to score our third. Concede our third, I should say. Ireland are in again. I cannot cover at the bottom of a ruck. That is three tries. Ireland have scored. England have nothing at all. This is a travesty for the Six Nations chances. You saw Nicholls had to commit the phase before, straight in between right winger and scrum half. Too easy. And a try is scored for Ireland. Well, I don't know what has gone so horribly wrong here. We look so good in recent weeks, now just dreadful. We can't hold on to the ball for more than a phase. Ireland are carving us up to ribbons. Phase after phase after phase as well, I might add. As here is Sexton with his pretty little yellow boots. Just remember, Jonathan, they're not red. He tees red though, so you'll kick further with that, that's for sure. Well, it's 19-0. I don't know if I really believe the scoreline. But we are in huge trouble here. Absolute huge trouble. What do we do, Nathan? What do we do? We need the ball. Left side. Goes high. Perfectly played. But still, Ireland pick it up. I don't know what we do to get the ball here. Their offloading is just ridiculous. Uh-oh. No. Nathan. Get out of that ruck. We are in so much trouble if they break. It's all right, we've survived. Short side though. Oh, very good hit. Still, we don't have the ball. That's the real issue for me at the moment. We are down by three tries. And, oh yes, we got the ball. All right. No, you idiots, you absolute clown. You kicked the ball away for a gain of what? 20 meters? Oh, Nathan, you dick. Get out of there. For shit's sake, that is ridiculous. We have had nothing go our way today at all. We can't even go into contact and we lose the ball. Stats, 72-28 is possession. That is to complete destruction. Line breaks 9-2. I don't even believe we've made two tackles. Three times as many. I cannot explain this. Why have we dropped off so badly versus Ireland? Our handling errors 3-0. We've kicked the ball more with the wind against us. We've just not had a good game at all. And the second half needs to change dramatically. Well, this is going to be one hell of a bad day in our Six Nations chances. Right, Sexton's got it with his pretty yellow boots. What can we cook up here? Hopefully, something delicious. Because my God, we need it. Short side. That's not bad. Not a bad play. Nicholls chips over the top. Runs for the line. Can he do it himself? He might. He can't. He hangs on to it. Oh, come on. It's 3-on-1 of the breakdown. And we lose the damn ball. So Driscoll I told you that wasn't a good sign to have an O'Driscoll at 13. Right, what's the go here? We're not even on high. We're not on that 2-4-2. I'm not in the line. This is the first time we've been down this half part of the field. Are we mauling? We're mauling. Good. Use width. Look at that. Look at it. Look at the defense. Look at their defense. This is a try. Have to be scored. Come on. It's 2-on-1. It's a try. Yes, to England. Finally. It had to be done. It looks like Sam Stanley's the one to score it. 2-on-1 overlap. Oh my God, if we did not score that try, this episode may not have gone out because the monitor would have been out the window. Carrying the ball in one hand, always the guaranteed way to place it down, Sam. But their defense all went towards the mall, trying to shut it down. To our credit of our players, our attack stayed wide. Relative good width on our attack there. And that was the difference. Once it got in the hands of Nicholls, Stanley outside him, it was curtains. Now we need kicks, we need points. Yes, good kick. We're back, 19-7. This game is not over yet. We've got the wind at our backs, but I don't know if we want to kick it away too much. We need to win this kickoff though. Win the ball, it's going to curve back to Ireland. Of course it is. Get in there, boys, get in there, turn it over. We need the ball, 7 minutes into the second half. We cannot afford to concede again. That's a good tackle, good pressure. White jerseys in the ruck, no? Okay. Uh-oh, they got numbers here. They switched it in field. That's decent. Oh, no. Thought about it. Considered the option. Ireland's offload city is back in the full flow. They're just counting down the clock, though. Offload close to breakdown. We're in trouble now. They come back. Oh, good tackle, Nathan. Let it go dead. Yes. I like that. Take the man out. Good stuff, Nathan. Now this one is going to go absolute country mile. Not really. Is he going to kick back? No. Passes. Opening up the options. Do England have this covered? Yes, they do. Still Ireland with the ball. We need to score before the hour mark or we could be really struggling. If only we could have got it off the kickoff, would have made the world of difference. Breaking just about. Ireland doing a good job. Banahan is back with me. He's making his way to the wing as the pendulum swings. This is a turnover. This has got to be a turnover. Oh, shit's sake, it's so close. Oh, it still is. Still is a turnover. Come on, left side. Oh. Come on, Matty. I'll help you up, buddy. I'll help you. Oh, wow. I won that without even... Okay. Nice work. Can I have my control back? Thank you. Oh, no. You serious? They turn it over so quickly. Yeah, we don't get that option. Turn over. So slow at getting up. So this is isolated. Why didn't we get that ball back? This is absolute rubbish. The way we're playing at the moment, complete and utter rubbish. Give it to Nathan. No. Ah, he's in the ruck. Get up. Where's the ball? I can't see it. Oh, we've lost it. Oh. This is an infuriating match at the moment. Absolute infuriating.
Crouch. Bind.
60 minutes is up.
Set.
Right, this is where we attack pretty well from before. Win the scrum, England. They'll cover their fullback nicely across to cover me and Banahan, so We're going to go that way? No, we go the left. Now we go back this way. Banahan, go! Not the touch though, Matty. Oh, good pass to Break. Go, Break, go! You've got Atwood with you. Oh, come on, white jerseys, yes! Banahan was the difference there. Swing it wide. Good work. Excellent work, England. Nicholls is there. We need to score in the next 5 minutes. Busting run away too. That was good work. This is it right now. It's Nicholls. Shovels it. Oh no! He's knocked it on! Would have been easier to catch the ball and score a try. I don't believe it. We've lost this game now. We had to score off that phase. Ireland are just throwing the ball around hanky-panky. And they're going forward. It's karma right there. Just when you thought you were going to go the length of the field, the ref says, nope. Crouch. Back Bind. You go.
Set.
Well, England, it's up to the forwards who've just gone instantly backwards. We are slowly coming back. I don't think we're going to win this, though. No, we've lost it. That surely will signal game over. Unless there's a big mistake or a kick right here. Can't see either happening. Bad day. England Six Nations hopes almost down the toilet now.
Release.
Still can't get hold of that ball. Oh, we're in trouble. Nicholls, he's got a lot of work to do. Oh, he does so well. Puts him into touch. Sit down. Been a bad day for Nathan, really. Not anything gone right for us. 5-man line out is what I've called. Oh, far out. We just can't do anything right. This is bullshit. Well, what do we do here? We are absolutely stuffed. And I am in a world of trouble out here. Oh, good tackle Break. Again, it's too little too late. If we win the line out, we've got 5 minutes to go full length of the field. Ain't going to happen to get it back and then go full length of the field again. We butchered too many chances. Atwood's got that at the front. Now, can we suck them in again? Nope. Use the back line. Or just go yourself, Stanley. Good work. Nicholls! Has he got the speed? Has he got all the way? Can he do it? The chase might have been off. Oh, Nicholls! He's done it! Whoa, that was close. But is there time for a restart? Superb Break. Well, it wasn't Break that made the break, but it was a superb bust. And Nicholls had that fend always ready. Perfect pass. Fullback. No, it was the outside centre, O'Driscoll. Coming at pace. But he's held him out by an absolute feather. Davies, that's the man who made the break. Couldn't remember his name, the fly half. He needs to get this over quickly. We may have time. We will have time for a restart. It's 19-14. I don't know if my fluent-juiced voice is going to hold this out if we get the victory. This is cutthroat right here. They hit it straight down the middle. England secure the ball. They get numbers to the breakdown. Which way do we go? To the right. Not a bad little run. Not bad! Oh, Nicholls almost! Oh, if I could have just had a little bit more of a head start. There goes full time. Davies is the man, keeping it tight. Nicholls just getting up from that last hit. We're going to the left. Stanley, good work. Nicholls is there, good work, Nathan. Popped away. Atwood, touch isolated though. Nicholls again is there. Oh, whatever! Absolute bullshit! There's no way he could have turned it over that fast! There's full time! What an absolute crap way to finish the game! Nicholls was standing on Atwood's head! Over the ruck! Yet the ball was stolen. Absolute rubbish! That ruck had well and truly formed. It was still saying call pass when I was trying to enter the ruck. Absolute rubbish. Stolen. This game by Ireland, I don't think they deserved to win. They had a great first half, but they were rubbish. Absolute crap in the second. Three tries, if only we could have stopped them once more. Brown, Finn and Barnes, 3-4 Ireland. Sexton, 2 out of 3. That's where we would have won it. Stanley and Nicholls for England. Davies, 2 out of 2. I'm a bit annoyed. I'm rather annoyed, to be perfectly honest. We should have won that game. We should have had more chance. Atwood did fantastically. And to have that ball stolen before he hits the ground even is just rubbish. Just rubbish as well. Stats-wise, it says Ireland has more possession, 61-39. They also did us on territory. Handling errors evened up in the second half. We only made one, they made two. Line breaks, so we were carved up by that offloading in the first half from Ireland. 13-8, we just couldn't find a way back despite dominating the second 40 minutes. Well, Nathan Nicholls, 2 line breaks, try scored, 7 tackles, won a contest and made one handling error as well, but should have been a victorious player as well. That one will hurt, and it could really kill our chances of a Six Nations trophy. All right, so our tasks for the match were running metres 59. We did manage 249, so easily eclipsed that. Won a contest, which for the first time we actually get those stat bonuses. 2 line breaks, needed 1. Didn't bother with a drop goal, of course, and handling errors. We made 0, had to make less than 2. So for our stats, we get 0.8 on fitness, 1 full point on speed, 0.4 on acceleration, 0.3 on breaking tackle, and 1.5 on passing and catching, 1.8 on mental, and 1.3 on discipline. All right, so overall, a really good performance, 4.89. Would have been a good 5-plusser if we could have got the win, which is so disappointing to not pull that in as well. But good runs, good running meters is the key thing there. 249 getting us 1 point. Kicking meters as well helps. But overall, the result is the killing disappointments. We're back though for Bath, so we won't actually get to see the Six Nations table. No, we don't. We just get to see the FIFA Premiership one, which is a bit stupid, really, when we can't look at a different competition. Despite that, we'll have a look at what's coming up next. I have a feeling Ireland may run away with the Six Nations now. Let's see if we can have a look at this one here. And no, we can't see a table, but we've got France and Scotland following the Harlequins match. Who is back in the team? Okay, we've got Devoto at 10. Ollie Devoto is at 10. Oh, wow, this team has changed a lot. Burgess is at 12. Which means that Henson is out. Watson is on the right for Banahan. Nicholls is starting at fullback. So we've lost the English players, Banahan and Henson, even though he's not English. And it seems Burgess and Watson have come in. Ford's on the bench. Rocket Aguni's on the bench. Banahan's on the bench. And it seems like that's all that's changed. So those guys have been benched. Nicholls is starting, 85 rated as well. The best player in the back line. Bit of a concern with these guys here, Burgess especially. How's he going to fare? Are we going to go downhill a bit after this? Oh, it's going to be interesting. Would have liked to have seen Ford still there, but we give Devoto the chance. My good friend Banahan, shame we don't see him on the right anymore. Let's wrap up today's episode though. We'll see what our stats look like in our interest, even though it hasn't changed. We don't really need to see the interest, do we? The stats overall though, the changes, most notably our speed, up 1, it's 82 now, which is a good little extra as well on top of that. Catching and passing getting good boost as well. Seeing 73 on passing now, and our catching, unbelievably, still down at 56, but it's making its way up. 85 rated. A loss, though, really hurts. We'll have to see next episode where we sit on the Six Nations ladder. But until then, thanks for watching. Hope you've enjoyed. And until next time, take care.